Fractal, watch out. There's a new airflow case that's making its way onto the scene, and it can take a 420 millimeter AIO without removing those massive 200 millimeter airflow fans. Introducing the ASUS ProArt PA602, it's a heck of a PC case that was way less expensive than I thought. It's a case that's targeted at content creators with some ingenious features like a lockdown power button, a button to control fan speed, and rollers, or for you anti-RGB fanatics who want a case that doesn't look like it was designed 20 years ago. But enough about the possibilities. Let's build in it, show you airflow, and see how the build we are about to showcase also performs in games. Oh, and if you like seeing new cases with the latest and greatest components, why not go ahead and slap that subscribe button with that like button and ring that notification bell so that you get notifications when we post videos like this right here in Robitech. Let's jump into the build. This is the ProArt PA602 case. It is very, very big, but what really, like the key thing about this, and I like you guys ready, here it is right here. I'm gonna find, I think the other one's right here. 200 millimeter fans. Look at that, 200 millimeter fans. It's got top mounting for a 420 millimeter AIO. You also have like, so again, cooling in this is a great option. Now, price-wise, looks like we're looking at like $269 for this case. It's actually a relatively well-priced case. The other thing too is it can do wheelies. It's got wheels that are included with this case that are really, really good for people who want to build, who want to have a creator type PC. What we did is I worked with ASUS and we came up with a build that's actually a little bit more reasonable. Given that the case is $267, what we actually have here is we have a $2,600 creator build. It's using a Core i7-14700K, which again, you have those E cores, which allow you to do all of your offloading and things like that. And then you can prioritize your P cores for things like rendering, high computation, all that sort of stuff. You have the ProArt Z790 creator Wi-Fi. The thing that's so nice about the Z790 creator Wi-Fi is it's got two PCIe 5 slots with the ProArt GPUs. So like the 4060 Ti, the 4070 or 4080, you can actually dual slot GPUs, which is great for high level rendering for people like DJs, 3D renderers, etc. You've got three terabytes of Gen 4 NVMe storage. You've got 32 gigs of DDR5 at 6,000 mega transfer. You've got the ProArt PA602. The cooler, guys, is actually the brand new cooler from ASUS. It's the ASUS ProArt LC420. And the other thing too that's so crazy about this, it's an LC420. With ASUS's overclocking technology, with a 420 millimeter AIO, you can use ASUS's AI stuff to basically overclock your CPU. And then this gives you tons of headroom for a 14700K to be able to do so. And we're gonna do a little bit of that on today's show as well, which is actually pretty cool. So, terabyte in. Putting it low so I can lift. Ugh. There we go. So we'll start with the back here. Little buttons, you just push the buttons and they pop right off. Latch, push that latch and then this pops open. At the top, basically you lift and then this pops off. So very, very easy there. But 200 millimeter fans, guys, 200 millimeter fans. These 200 millimeter fans are capable of 190.2 CFM. Let's go ahead and pop our beautiful Mobo in. All right, let's grab our AIO. We have our bracket, and now we're gonna grab our AIO. All Okay, so I'm gonna worry about doing this on the other side, just given how this, how different this kind of this case is in that regard. Okay, so we're gonna run this down. There we go. Okay, now we just got to throw some thermal paste on this. So it makes it really easy. Now let's grab our ProArt 4060 Ti. So here we go, 4060 Ti, we got sag bracket in place. We're basically in good shape there. Okay, so there we go, guys. GPU is now installed. Look at that. Okay, so let's now put our power supply in, which is actually one of the reasons that after I got to use these PSUs. So this is the ASUS TUF 750 watt PSU. This is their new one. And honestly, guys, I love these PSUs. Turn this around, we'll use the wheels here, wheelie it. There's our SATA. Okay, so now let's grab our shroud. There it is, guys. Sealed, signed, and delivered. There is our build. Nice and clean, very little in terms of RGB or anything like that, but it's gonna look really nice when it's, I mean, there will be almost no light. We turn it on. There we go. Wow. I couldn't even hear it turn on, but I do know it turned on. So before we go too far into the rest of this video, let's just review exactly what we put inside of this PC. First off, we wanted to build a more affordable, creator-focused PC that's good for not just gaming, but also gives you the option for photography, videography, animation, music, science and simulation, advanced productivity, etc. First, let's start with the Intel Core i7-14700K. This is the gem of the Raptor Lake refresh that pops out a few more E-cores for megatasking while using the P-cores it's already got for the aforementioned tasks we were listing above. We also have that crazy ProArt Z790 Creator motherboard that we paired with the ProArt 4060 Ti that we specifically used, or if you want, you can do the 4070, 4070 Super, the 4080, the 4080 Super. They're all ProArt GPUs that can be used in those dual PCIe 5x16 safe slots for dual GPU workloads because of their special 2.5 slot design. A unique feature and why this build can be so good for a budding creator. We also got the standard 6000 mega transfer G-Skill RAM, 3 terabytes of Kingston NVMe Gen 4 storage, and a 750 watt PSU, which allows you to pop in another 4060 Ti if you want. And all for $2,600 with good room for expansion. Now on to airflow. Using our Smoke Genie for visualization, you can see that we intake via those dual 200 millimeter fans with the top fan feeding that ProArt LC420 millimeter AIO that's basically available finally this month. and the bottom 200 millimeter fan feeding our ProArt 4060 Ti. For exhaust, we have a single 140 millimeter fan in the rear and the 420 millimeter AIO at the top, along with a very special exhaust port in the tempered glass that helps alleviate that very positive pressure situation we have inside of this case. It's good for dust and also for keeping the case from trapping too much hot air. Okay, now for thermals, which is very exciting given that we have those massive 200 millimeter fans and that crazy ProArt LC 420 millimeter AIO. If you watch the live stream, which you can check out right here, we actually tested stock, which means multi-core enhancement turned on. We tested overclock using AI overclocking tools built into the motherboard, and we also tested with stock Intel settings, meaning we turned off all of the extras that the motherboard has. For stock settings, we saw an average of 95 degrees Celsius while under load and Cinebench score in the high 34K range. We used ASUS AI overclocking, which we saw 6,000 megahertz on two cores. We saw it hitting 96 on average with a few TJ Maxx pops into the 100 degrees and north of a 35K Cinebench score. Now for stock Intel settings and what we recommend, if you want to keep your temps more manageable, we saw things drop to 82 degrees while under load, which is expected given the 250-ish watt TDP the CPU was throwing at the LC420 cooler versus the 350 plus watts that we were seeing when this was overclocked or using all that multi-core enhancement stuff. Oh, and for idle temps, we saw everything sitting at a nice and frosty 29 degrees. And for gaming, well, you got nothing to worry about because it was sitting at a nice and pleasant 60 degrees. Now, before we jump into all those gaming performance benchmarks, let's talk about the build experience because there is a lot to kind of unpack here. First and foremost, this really is a straightforward build to work with, and there is a lot to like. But there are a few things that also make it feel a bit like a true V1 product. First, let's talk about the AIO mounting. It's pretty straightforward in the fact that you have to remove the bracket, which the screws are hidden behind a magnetic plate, by the way. More on that a little bit later. But once you get it all out and you get a 420 millimeter AIO mounted, you will notice there is no really good way to run your cables. It's like they forgot where you're supposed to put the cables. And what I had to do was squish the cables against the fans and run them across the top to the hole in the front of the case so they wouldn't just be hanging out of the top all haphazardly. Which takes us to the second weird bit of this case, this little box in the back of the case, which they use to control like the bundle of cables coming from the front of the case. It's really cool, but if you need to run additional cables from the front, it can be a challenge given the front of the cover has like a plastic lip on it. And what that does is it reduces the number of the cables that can actually run through the box. I spent a good 5 or so minutes just trying to route things through it because routing around it would be kind of odd because you have like this beautiful place where everything's running through and it's like cables going everywhere. No, you want them to run through the one thing. Okay, so thermals were impressive, as you would expect. Build experience had some minor kinks, but nothing too messy. How did this $2,600 dual-purpose build also perform in games? Well, let's kick it off with Cyberpunk 2077 at 1440p with ray tracing on ultra and DLSS set to auto. With no frame generation on, we hit 64.60 frames per second. Sounds like a nice solid way to spend, you know, a quality night in Night City, not getting murdered, hopefully. For Starfield, we tested 1440p with everything on ultra and DLSS set to balance. We saw 60-ish FPS on both the planet, and we also saw that similarly around space. Again, perfect for games like Starfield, and you can expect even stronger numbers at 1080p. Next up, we have Forza Horizon 5, again at 1440p, with graphics set to extreme, DLSS set to auto, and frame generation on, we were looking at 229 FPS, perfectly fine for some racing, you might say. For Call of Duty Modern Warfare 3, again, set at 1440p, extreme graphics, DLSS set to balance, and frame generation on, we're sitting at 237 FPS, which is perfect for some campaign. But if you want to do MP on low settings, you're looking at north of 260 FPS with raw 1440p. For Shadow of the Tomb Raider, 1440p with the highest graphical preset and DLSS set to balance, you're looking at 267 FPS. Finally, rounding out the single player games, we have Tiny Tina's Wonderland with graphics set to badass and FSR 2.0 set to balance, we saw 234 FPS. Let's talk about MP. For MP titles, we're kicking it off with Apex Legends. With graphics maximized for competitive gameplay, we saw 298 FPS at 1440p. And finally, Fortnite. Again, graphics set for competitive gameplay to maximize frame rate, we saw an almost, you know what, it was downright unplayable at 395 FPS. So there it is, our $2,600 build inside of the brand new ASUS ProArt PA602. We gave you a build, we gave you airflow, we gave you thermals, we gave you build thoughts, and we gave you game performance. Phew! But enough about what I think. What do you think? What do you think of the build? Did you stop watching because of the lack of RGB? Are you planning to build in this brand new Epic Airflow case? Let us know all of that down in the comments below. And don't forget, you can also watch our full review of the PA602 right here. Now, while you're down there, make sure you slap that subscribe button, whip that like button, and ring that notification bell so you get a notification each time we post a video like this right here on Roby. Also, if you have questions or you want to discuss builds like this, make sure you join our Discord server over at discord.gg/RobyTech. Who knows? You might make a friend. Also, feel free to follow me on all the other socials at RobyTech, absolutely everywhere. Thank you so much. That's it for me. Thanks for watching. We look forward to seeing you on the next one.